You got married at 17, Bruce, and how long did that marriage last? How old was the girl that you married?
She was like 19.
She was 19. So technically, you were being statutory raped.
For a couple of years. It was awesome.
For a couple of years. It was awesome, he says.
All right, Cody.
All right, clown. What do you have to say today? By the way, didn't you call actual pedophiles great role models for millions of children? But we'll get to that in a second. Carry on.
Someone has been alleging for years now that you knowingly committed a crime against her when she was a minor. Crime against her.
All right, let's talk about this. These are the states in which Cody Ko has done absolutely nothing wrong, nothing immoral, nothing illegal. He's good. And these are the states in which he's a criminal who needs to go to jail for a long time. How does that make any sense? It doesn't. Yet people online are unanimously agreeing that he's done a horrendous crime and needs to be punished for it, probably severely. He needs to be locked up. This is the line between Florida and another state. There's something that's illegal in the taco shop that's completely legal in the parking lot. Crime in the taco shop, fun time in the parking lot. So if you're having a meal here with your date who's under 18 years old, and after you have eaten you want to what you need to do is just cross the street and boom, you're in the clear. Have at it, champ. How is this the law? And how are people pretending to accept this as something logical and rational? I understand that laws differ from state to state when it comes to firearms or illegal substances or something like that, but the age of consent is something that's very serious. People take it seriously. They tie it to pedophilia and sexual assault and other very heavy accusations. It's not like having an ounce of weed in one state versus 5 ounces of weed in another state, and that's the line of criminality. No, that's completely different. And again, the age of consent is 18. Only in 12 states versus 38 states in which the age of consent is under 18. By the way, for those who don't know what I'm talking about, there is a YouTuber by the name of Cody Ko, and it's been revealed recently when he was 25, he had sex with a 17-year-old girl who was and still is a famous YouTuber, Tana Mongeau. And that's illegal in the state in which they were living at the time, Florida. And everybody's dogpiling on him online because he did a crime. Now, I don't think they actually believe that, because if you believe that what he did is a crime, you would be protesting the law in the vast majority of the country. It's always been laughable to me how Americans take the law blindly to be the point of reference for morality and ethics and the line between right and wrong without even the slightest bit of thinking about it. Americans can't comprehend a sentence like a crime is legal. What do you mean? It's a crime, yet you are allowed by the law to do it. Slavery was legal. That's probably the only example they understand. Other than that, of course what's legal is what's moral. And by the same token, what's illegal is immoral. They're so stupid, it pisses me off. Go to any of these people who are clowning on Cody Ko right now on X or on YouTube and ask them, what do you think of a 13-year-old, actual minor, according to federal law, taking hormone blockers, then going through top or bottom surgery that will destroy their life forever and their body forever, and they will express their total support to that because it's legal, so it must be good. This person himself, called Chris from Mr. Beast, the person who transitioned and abandoned his entire family, his wife and his child, and the person who said on X that he likes cartoon child pornography. Look this word up. See what it means if you wanna vomit. This person is a positive role model for millions of children, according to this clown. And he said that when he was responding to Sunny V2 video, when that was the bandwagon of the week.
There'll be millions of queer kids who look up to him, although this doesn't necessarily mean that it'll add any value to the video.
How would millions of children having a positive role model not be a value add to a video? You're just saying things that don't make sense. A positive role model?
A positive role model?
And his audience agrees with him, and if you don't, you are the bigot. Of course it's a positive role model for children to look up to put hormones in your body, have surgery done on you, abandon your family, and watch cartoon child pornography. I'm careful with my words here. You know why he thinks that's a great role model? Because it's not illegal. Although it is illegal now to transition children in certain states, because you know what? Morality depends on the lines of the states. You want to talk about pedophilia? How about a person who thinks a 4-year-old is a good-looking bitch? Would you attack Mr. Beast himself for having this person on? Like you attacked Cody Ko for having a friend who did nothing even close to the ballpark of that shit. And by the way, just yesterday, things came out about this person, Chris, that I haven't looked into yet, but it doesn't look good. But who would be surprised at this point? But it's not fashionable nowadays to attack anything attached to Mr. Beast, so fucking call it a day. Now, there is a YouTube YouTuber by the name of Moist Critical. You probably know him. He's pretty famous in certain circles. And he makes videos with like OnlyFans models. So basically porn. He talks about porn all the time. He was involved in the production of a porn film in the past and talked about it endlessly. If you asked him, what do you think of porn? He would think it's okay to do porn. What do you mean? Like porn is cool. How about gay porn? No, well, that's even better. What, are you homophobic or something? How about gay slash trans orgy porn of people who are of legal age? They're not really like, they're not old people. They're just of legal age. They pass the threshold. Oh, then that's fine. Of course it's fine. He can't even think outside of the parameters of the law. What's legal cannot by definition be wrong. But having sex with someone under 18, even by a few months, is disgusting and a crime and all these things. He loves to grandstand. He loves to virtue signal. Now, you might think that I'm saying that Cody Ko did nothing wrong. Now, my belief is that people shouldn't have sex outside of marriage. If you're not married, you shouldn't have sex. Age and consent are not tied to sex. If you are 50 years old, having sex with another 50-year-old, your age and consent doesn't make your sexual encounter moral or right or ethical or correct or permissible. It's still a crime. That's my real view. What pisses me off is people who promote porn and transgenderism, lecturing the rest of the country about sexual morality and accusing everyone else of being a pervert except them. They are the ultimate arbiters of truth, even when they stream to their audience of mostly children events where porn sites are sponsors. And when he was asked about it, he said, well, I didn't stream porn, I just streamed the event in which the name of the website was blasted everywhere. Why? Because streaming porn is illegal, but advertising porn sites isn't. That's his only way of comprehending shit. The flack that Muslims get because the only criteria for the morality or lack thereof of a sexual encounter in Islam is whether or not said encounter was marital or not. Did it happen within marriage? Is insane, although it is the correct criteria.
What do you think the age of consent should be, Sneko?
This is not an important conversation.
You don't think f***ing kids or not is an important conversation? What do you think the age of consent should be? If you want to be consistent, you don't think anything updates, just tell us what you think it should be.
I think it should be at a developed age. That's
what is a developed age? If you had to set a law for it, what would you set it? What would you set it about?
I'd say it's a developed age.
No, answer the question, you f***ing pussy. Holy f***, you're such a cowardly f***. Stand up for what you believe in. If you actually are f***ing Muslim, you're actually Islamic, then stand up for your f***ing beliefs. Every other Muslim scholar online will do this. Do it. Stand tall on it.
And that's Disney, the ultimate freak when it comes to this shit. There isn't a perversion in the world that he wouldn't celebrate wholeheartedly. He would call you a bigot if you don't like trans women shitting in your mouth for sexual pleasure. Yet he is still taking the moral high ground because people have this innate need to feel superior morally to other people, and justifying that by doing the right thing is obviously too inconvenient to just attack other people. It costs $0 to virtue signal on Twitch. The only wrong thing in the sexual encounter in question between those two people is that it was outside of marriage. The age gap is irrelevant here, and if you think that's weird, well, that's your problem. I don't see it that weird. 25 and 17, that's fine in my opinion, and even a bigger age gap might make it weird for some people, but it definitely doesn't make it immoral. What does make it immoral is its casual nature, something that these people would call you insane for mentioning. You are a crazy fanatic that should be laughed out of the room if you mentioned for a second that people of opposing sexes should get married before having sex. What are you even talking about, grandpa? The line of morality is obviously age and not anything else, you weirdo. No, idiot, here's the correct answer. There's absolutely nothing wrong with a 25-year-old getting married to a 17-year-old and having kids together. If you think otherwise, you are wrong. I'm not saying that's my opinion, I'm saying that's the correct position. And it's the law in the vast majority of states, and it's the law all over the world. Yes, it was technically illegal in the state in which they were living at the time, but people who are attacking Cody Ko are in no position to lecture the rest of the world about what people should do with their bodies. Their only point is that it's the law. Well, you can ask them this question. If they didn't have sex here and had sex here, would that have made it okay? If they said yes, then what the fuck are you talking about? If they said no, then your criteria isn't really the law, is it? Then what's your actual criteria? I can tell you. It's what would make you appear more virtuous to your audience of children who don't know any better. American culture when it comes to sex is predatory. If you can have sex with someone and not marry them and just leave them after using them, that's fine. You're not obligated to spend the rest of your life with someone just because you had sex with them, although you should. You shouldn't have sex with anyone before you commit to them in marriage. I'm sorry that your mind has been rotted by your perverted culture, but that's the right thing to think. If your religion says otherwise, if your parents told you otherwise, they're all wrong. But that's the problem. In this day and age, sex is a transactional activity. It's isolated from love, isolated from commitment or marriage or anything. So what the law is trying to do is not to protect underage people from sex, it's to protect them from being exploited. But of course, the law is doing a horrible job at that. A 17-year-old having sex with another 17-year-old girl and getting her pregnant and then leaving her forever is not against the law. But a 20-year-old having sex with a 17-year-old within marriage and living with each other forever, with only 3 years of difference in age, is against the law. That's criminal behavior. Doesn't that make perfect sense? Now let's check out this little clown.
It's the same argument that people get into, like going, but in this country, the age of consent is... Look, it is illegal, okay? It is illegal.
The age of consent in Florida is 18. 17 is not 18. I know, bold statement.
She was a fan of yours at the time, adding an additional layer to the power dynamic you would have had over her.
This guy married a 19-year-old fan of his when he was 30. So a bigger age gap, but that was legal, so nothing to see here. Why the question of legality is the end of every discussion? By the way, I don't think that he did anything wrong. It's a big age gap, it's a little bit uncomfortable, but they now have 3 kids together and they are living happily ever after. So I don't really think he did anything wrong at all. Maybe it's better if 19-year-olds married 19-year-olds, but hey, they are not doing that. At least he married someone and created a family out of nothing. So he did a good thing. But if we are talking about weird, when it comes to age gaps, isn't your age gap bigger? Yes, it's 2 years later, but still, that's why I'm saying no one really believes that this was a heinous crime. No one really believes that a relationship between someone in their 20s and someone in their late or very late teens is an act of pedophilia. And even if it was, they wouldn't have cared. Otherwise, they would have cared about Chris. You have to understand something. The only reason they are raising all this hell is to gain cookie points in this cloud economy. Why aren't they concerned about the 4-year-old that inspired Chris to write that fucking tweet? Why aren't they concerned about the millions of kids who would go online and Google what the fuck is Loli and find out? Don't these people deserve some of your moral panic? The answer is of course not. Of course they don't give a genuine shit. At least not enough to make a video that might lose them a subscriber or two.